So, I'm sitting in the audience and Frank's talking, he's making a keynote speech, and he comes out and he kind of ignores everybody in the audience. He's dressed kind of aging, preppy. It was like he went from 15 to 55 without any tweed, he had khaki pants and a tweed blazer on. And he shuffled across the stage and he read. And I listened for 20 minutes and I had no idea what he said. I don't remember a single word of it because I was just waiting for him to be finished. So he would leave, and I'd get a costume or something like that. And so he finished, and I was sitting at the end of the row, so I didn't have to say excuse me to anybody when I got up to leave. And I run down to the lobby, and it's empty except for this coffee stand over the corner. And so I figured, he left. And maybe he's out back having a smoke or something. But I'll wait a second. While I'm waiting, I'm kind of refining the question I have to ask him, if I'm going to ask him. And I'm thinking, if I see him, what should I say? How far away should he be? 15 feet? Should I shout it? Should I make him very close? Should I call Mr. Conroy? I can't call Frank. So I'm like, Mr. Conroy, excuse me, Mr. Conroy, I want to ask you one question. The one question I wanted to ask him was, if I got into Iowa, I'd apply, and if I got in at age 32, would I be too old to attend? That was my only question. Not would I get in or anything like that. And so finally he comes walking through the door. And he kind of is shuffling toward me and he's pinching his head down a little bit and blowing his nose into his handkerchief. And he looks up and when he's about there, I said, excuse me, Mr. Conroy, I have a question I want to ask you. And he keeps going. I said, I've applied to the writer's Iowa Writers Workshop. And without looking at me, he just said, you win $800. And I said, well, I just want to ask you one question. He said, let me get a cup of tea. So I watch him walk over to the coffee cart, buy a cup of tea, pour sugar in. And he starts walking back toward me. And he stirs his tea. And he kind of finishes. And he looks up, and I'm standing there. And he smiles, and I figure, oh, well, he had a cold. He just. Now he's ready to talk to me. He's happy to talk to me. So he smiles at me and he puts his hand out. He's going to shake my hand. So I put my hand out to shake his hand and he walked right past me because he saw a friend of his standing behind me. And so I was standing there like this as he walked by and I looked over my shoulder and they were walking off together. So I biked over to Key West. So my bike was chained outside, and it was locked, so I had a key. So to get home, I had to swear a key, a lock, a bike, the streets in Key West, the front porch gate, which I kicked in, ran up the stairs, and I'm still kind of swearing as I get home. And I'm looking at these bookshelves, which are 4 to 7 bookshelves in our house. My wife, Jody, comes out and says, what's wrong with you? What are you doing? And just as she says that, I see my copy of Stop Time, Frank's memoir. And I pull it down off the shelf, and she's still saying, what are you doing? And I start shredding the book, I start tearing it up. And I made sure to tear the title in half, and then I made sure that I tore his name in half. Kept ripping the book up, brought the pages into the kitchen, and just flung them at the trash can. And the ones that like kind of fluttered away, I had to curse at them even more, because I had to pick them up until I had them all in the trash can. And I stepped, I was able to step on it. And Becky's daughter is here tonight, and so I would say exactly what I said to my wife, but such was not from Frank Conroy. And see, I usually end the beginning of the book. This is the first part of the first chapter.